Hi there. My name is bearRimshot. Welcome to Casual Reviews with bearRimshot. Today we're going to talk about what I consider to be one of my favorite, or if not, my favorite childhood Disney movie to watch. But before I go into detail about it, let's talk about Disney. Yes, who doesn't love it? Parks, all the way to, of course, sequels. Who doesn't love sequels?
Oh my god, who the hell cares?
Anyway, we get to see a grown-up Winnie Darling with her husband Edward and a daughter named Jane who basically looks like a mix between Velma from Scooby-Doo and the girl from Tom and Jerry the movie, and a son named Danny who's basically just Michael Darling all dressed in green. Edward goes out and to the war. What war, you guys may ask? World War II. Anyway, Jane and Nana 2 were both walking on their way, running on their way to the cabin, and then as Jane arrives to the cabin, which Wendy Darling and Danny are both hiding, this is where Jane would then give Danny his birthday gift and wishes him a happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Daniel.
Yippee! Socks. Two of them.
That's fucking bullshit!
Anyway, Jane is getting ready for bed, this is where Wendy Darling would then encourage Jane to tell Danny Peter Pan stories, but Jane refused to do that, and thus Jane gets into a fight with not just Wendy Darling but also her brother Danny as well. And then comes my personal favorite song in the movie, I'll Try.
Oh, ain't that cute, but it's wrong.
Sometimes I wish I could imagine myself 10 years from now, out of college, living life without boundaries. But at the end of the day, it's just a step closer to the future. The future tends to unfold as it should. Well, at least I think it does. Somebody's friend,
take anything you want. And I'm just gonna say, people, why Huey Tune More? Why didn't you include this song in your top 11 tear-jerking songs in an animated feature?
I'm a people's person. We're on the same page here, aren't we?
Anyway, when Captain Hook Mr. Smee and the pirate crew arrived at the Darling's house. This is where they would then take Jane from Winnie Darling and for some reason kidnap Jane and use this green thing which looks like Daphne's scarf. Anyway, Captain Hook, Mr. Smee, and the pirate crew all take Jane to all kidnap Jane and take her away to Neverland. Captain Hook, for some reason, uses Jane as bait to feed the octopus. Peter Pan would then rescue Jane, and then have the octopus go fly up, and then the octopus goes down Captain Hook. And this is where Peter Pan and Jane would both then fly together through Neverland. And oh boy, is it fun to see Peter Pan and Jane both fly together.
I have a bad feeling about this.
And then Jane gets to meet the Lost Boys. Jane walks away and tries to get back home. And is it me, or do the fish above look like Cosmo and Wanda from the Fairly Odd Parents?
Of course!
I love the smell of sewers in the morning.
And then this is where we get to see Mr. Smee, Captain Hook.
I can't fight these urges.
And then this is where we get to see Jane trying to go back home, but unfortunately she failed. And then this is where Peter Pan would then teach Jane how to fly. And then this is where Jane would then say this.
And I especially don't believe in fairies.
Anyway, this is the moment where Jane gets depressed, and then this is where Peter Pan and the Lost Boys would all then go check out on how Tinkerbell is doing.
Little Tinkerbell!
Hey, put a cork in it!
Shh! What?
What did she say, Peter?
If we don't get Jane to believe in—
SPAGHETTI!
Tink's light's gonna go out.
No! It burns!
Anyways, as Jane hears Captain Hook crying, Captain Hook would then promise Jane as she would never harm Peter Pan whatsoever.
I, Captain James Hook, do hereby swear not to harm a single hair on Peter Pan's head.
Peter Pan, the Lost Boys, would then try to find Jane, and then this is where Jane, Peter Pan, and the Lost Boys would all sing and go sing a musical number together. And then, as Toodles blasted the toot, this is where Captain Hook would then lie to Jane and then pull a piece of hair coming from Peter Pan himself. And then this is where Jane would then go up to Tinkerbell and then apologizes to Tinkerbell for what she said about her. And then Tinkerbell comes back alive.
Yes! Yes!
Oh, excuse me, I need to piss.
Hey guys, look, I'm naked. Yeah, made you look.
God, who the hell cares?
You smell like shit.
Smells like Jesus.
Here's what I believe we need to do. Give a...
Don't interrupt me.
Tigers!
I have quite a lot to get through.
And it will be.
Oh, you sick bastard!
Say your prayers, Peter Pan.
Anyways, this is the moment where Jane and Tinkerbell would then both go out and rescue Peter Pan and the Lost Boys. And then, and if that wasn't enough, this is the moment where we do get to see Jane and the Lost Boys kicking butts out of the pirates themselves, and then we do get to see...
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more. Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
Eat crack. It's your idea.
Jane gets the key from Captain Hook. And then Jane frees Peter Pan. And then this is where Captain Hook would then choke Jane with his hook. And then this is the moment where Captain Hook gets defeated once again. And then this is the moment where Captain Hook would then get chased by the octopus.
Got your anchor.
Wow!
Captain always
die.
I don't wanna be a good captain.
Anyway,
give me your best shot, Tink.
Sure.
And then this is the moment where Jane goes fly back home, and then this is where Peter Pan would then reunite with Winnie Darling, and then Edward came back home from the war, and then Jane, Wendy, Danny, and Edward all lived happily ever after. And that was Return to Neverland. So, what did I think of this movie?
Let yourself go to Pizza Hut. Let yourself go to Pizza Hut. When it's pizza you want, nothing else will do. When there's no stopping until you're through. When you're laughing and smiling and shooting the breeze. When you wanna let loose and be as free as you please. Let yourself go to Pizza Hut. Let yourself go to Pizza Hut.
Let me say this, people.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
That this is one of the best animated sequels that I ever saw in my entire life. It's as good as The Rescuers Down Under. It's as good as Fantasia 2000. It's as good as Aladdin and the King of Thieves. It's as good as the Lion King 1.5. It's as good as the Lion King 2 Simba's Pride. It's as good as Cinderella 3, A Twist in Time. It's as good as Kronk's New Groove. It's as good as Bambi 2. It's as good as Toy Story 2. It's good as Toy Story 3. It's good as Monsters University. It's as good as Shrek 2. It's good as Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2. It's as good as An American Tale 5 Goes West. It's good as Kung Fu Panda 2. It's good as How to Train a Dragon 2. It's as good as An American Tale 5 Goes West. It's as good as All Dogs Go to Heaven 2. And heck, this movie even deserved to get the Academy Award for Best Animated Feature, as well as the Best Song for I'll Try. And heck, even this movie also even deserved to get a Grammy Award for Best Song. And I must ask, why, Animat? Why isn't Return to Neverland in your top 10 best animated sequels countdown?
That's because I'm gay!
But before I can go to more details on why I love the movie, let's move on to trivia time.
No! Oh, please, no!
The music in this movie is written by Joel McNeely, who also wrote the music for Star Wars Shadows of the Empire, The Jungle Book 2, Mulan 2, Cinderella 3, A Twist in Time, The Fox and the Hound 2, and all the Tinkerbell movies. Originally, Return to Neverland was supposed to get a straight-to-video home video release, but then when Disney CEO Michael Eisner did get to see Return to Neverland for himself, this is the moment where he would then decide to give it a theatrical release due to the fact that it had good quality. And now, let's talk about all the characters and their voice actors. First off, let's talk about my personal favorite Disney character of all time, Jane, who is voiced by Harriet Owen, who would also star in live-action TV programs from the 90s like Galaglass. But let me say this, people, that I find Jane to be way more likable than Wendy Darling. And also, Disney, if you're watching this, I would really, really appreciate it if I can see her appear in at least one episode of Jake and the Neverland Pirates, as well as in Kingdom Hearts 3, as well as appear as a figure in Disney Infinity.
No!
And then, of course, we've got Peter Pan, voiced by Blaine Weaver, who had also voiced Peter Pan in other recent appearances like The Lion King 1.5 and Connect Disneyland Adventures. And then of course we've also got the elegant Captain Hook, who is voiced by none other than Corey Burton.
No!
He's the current voices of other Disney characters as well, like Mole from Atlantis The Lost Empire, Judge Claude Frollo from The Hunchback of Notre Dame, and Shere Khan from The Jungle Book. Here's an interesting fact that I'd like to share with you. Did you know that Corey Burton is an admirer, a fan, and a student of the original voice of Captain Hook himself, Hans Conried? Anyway, then of course we got Mr. Smee, who would who would be voiced by Jeff Bennett, who not only voiced Mrs. Me in other appearances since then, like Jake and the Neverland Pirates, Kingdom Hearts, and all that stuff, but he's also best known for doing voices like Johnny Bravo, Kowalski in the Penguins of Madagascar, the TV series, that is, and Petrie from The Land Before Time. And here are two more facts I'd like to share with you. Did you know that Corey Burton, the voice of Captain Hook, has previously voiced Peter Pan in the Disney attraction Back to Neverland, and voiced Mr. Smee in Disney Villains' Revenge? Not only that, but also, did you guys also know that Corey Burton, the voice of Captain Hook, and Jeff Bennett, the voice of Mr. Smee, both have done some voices in various different Star Wars cartoons and video games? And now, since I got all the characters and voice actors out of the way, it's legacy time. Originally, there was supposed to be a third movie of Peter Pan called Peter Pan 3 Back to Neverland, but it got canceled by John Lasseter. Now, let me say this, people. Keep in mind, when I say this, people, that just because John Lasseter can cancel future sequels to the animated classics, that does not mean he should cancel future sequels to the animated classics. I mean, saying that canceling future sequels to the animated classics is considered to be a smart move, it's just like saying canceling Star Wars 1313, Star Wars First Assault, Season 6 of Star Wars The Clone Wars, and Star Wars Detours, and declaring all expanding universe stories we not get are all considered to be smart moves just because of how bad the Star Wars Holiday Special was. Now, in case if you guys haven't noticed, I created a petition about that I would love to be able to see more sequels of the animated classics. So far, I only got 19 signatures, and I encourage 81 of you guys to sign it. You can go check out the link below. And now for my final thoughts on the film. Overall, Return to Neverland is a must-watch for animation fans, Disney fans, and Peter Pan fans. As for non-Peter Pan fans, well, technically, you don't need to like Peter Pan in order for you to be able to like Return to Neverland. If you own either a Blu-ray player, a PlayStation 3, a PlayStation 4, or an Xbox One, go get the Special Edition Blu-ray. Or if you don't own either a Blu-ray player, nor a PlayStation 3, nor a PlayStation 4, nor an Xbox One, say you can go get either the original DVD, the Pixie Powered Edition DVD, or the Special Edition DVD. Or if you're a VHS collector, go get it on VHS. Or if you have an iTunes account, you can go get it on iTunes. And I give this movie the highest rating of 5 Jewish stars. And now be sure to join me for my first ever editorial, where I get to explain on why I worked so hard in making the epic battle saga bigger and better. Until then, I'll see you next time.
We both lie silent and still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we're miles apart inside.
Was it something I said or something I did? Did my words not come out right? Though I tried not to hurt you, though I tried.
Girl, I guess that's why they say every rose has its thorn. Just like every night has its dawn. Just like every kind.
sings a sad, sad song.